lot of superstars on the Toronto Maple Leafs. Take a look at the production coming from Austin Matthews, Mitch Marner, and William Nylander, three of the young studs that they have there in Toronto. But the question then, Mike Kelly, becomes this, because they're all making a lot of money up there, right? So which guy is the best long-term investment if you're the Toronto Maple Leafs?
Whichever one of them wants to give me some of that money. Those guys can afford it, right? I'll make a case for whoever wants to pay for it, those three players. No, honestly, though, Austin Matthews, to me, it's a no-brainer. He's the only guy of the three who is the best in the world at doing something that's, you know, very important. The other two are phenomenal players. Austin Matthews has scored more 5-on-5 goals than anybody since he came into the league, but he's adding to his toolbox, which is terrifying. You look at power play one-timers. This is something he added this past season. He took 52 one-timers on the power play, playing on that right side as off wing, more than he's taken in his career combined. So this guy is already one of, if not the best goal scorer in the NHL. I'm just going to add this weapon to my toolbox here. And that's terrifying because he's just finding more and more ways to score. So Austin Matthews, to me, his ability as a goal scorer is what separates him from the other guys. But almost everybody in the league is such a valuable asset to have. And I think he may be the best in the world at doing that once he incorporates more on the power play. And then another area he's adding to his toolbox is on the defensive side of the puck. I see so much raw ability to be a good defensive player with Austin Matthews. He's got a great defensive stick. You look at how he can play defense to help create offense for his team by tracking in the neutral zone. Stick checks, block passes, some of the things that we measure on the analytics side, he ranks highly in. For Austin Matthews, it's a matter of putting it together, doing it all the time, always being invested on the defensive side of the puck. That will take him to another level. But the raw tools are there for him to be, obviously he already is an elite goal scorer and a guy who can put up points, but a terrific all-around centerman. Another example here, stick checks, his ability to separate opponents from the puck with his stick and then turn that back into offense because he's such a deadly offensive player. So I see a player who's young still, already is potentially the best goal scorer in the world as he continues to develop on the power play, who has the ability to put it all together and be even better, which again is terrifying.
Yeah, I completely agree with you, Mike. I mean, just the raw ability, the size, the strength, the reach, the skill. I mean, and he plays a position that really, to me, helps drive winning. The centers and defensemen, to me, really help drive winning. And so I'm in complete agreement with you there. And you know the numbers way better than me, and we're showing you some of them right here that are really important numbers. But I'll go to the old school and say just the eyeball test for me is enough on Austin Matthews. Big, strong, long reach, great shot. I mean, what a talented young man.
But when you ask a lot of guys around the league, right, about Austin Matthews, they always talk about that shot and how deceptive it is and how you think, especially from a goalie's perspective. I know Kevin Weeks has shared this too, where goalies think they know where the guy's going to shoot, but they can't quite tell because he releases it at such different in such different ways. Would you agree with that, Mike?
Oh, no question. The release is deceptive. I mean, so he can catch when he was on the power play a couple seasons ago, he's on his strong side, the left side. He'll catch and release. It's almost like a one-timer how fast he can do it. So he's a weapon there. Now that he's developed that one-timer on the right side, which he would probably admit wasn't a strength, but it's something that he's gotten better at and he's scoring goals. Well, that's another weapon in the toolbox. When you watch him on his strong side, even at even strength with that shot, one thing he started to do, because he can pick the corners so well, is he started going five hole on goalies. Completely fools them because they go down into the butterfly, they try to get big, and then now it's going in between their legs. He continues to add dimensions to how he scores goals. And that, to me, is the scariest thing. He's not a one-trick pony. Even if you want to just focus on the shot, there's so many layers to that that make him a deadly goal scorer. He'll be piling up goals for years to come.
Yeah, and you know, one other thing, too, as you mentioned, Mike, with the way he shoots the puck, his ability to shoot pucks with his hands close together, high on the stick, most guys you see, they'll slide that hand down to kind of really flex the stick. It doesn't matter. He can catch a pass in traffic and not have his hand. His hands can be really almost anywhere on that stick, and he can rip it at high velocity and high accuracy. So I think that's another thing, another weapon, or as you say, another tool in his toolbox. Not a lot of guys have the ability to do that.